CMV is actually the largest virus in terms of its genome capacity that infects humans. Cytomegalovirus, or CMV, as we commonly call it, is a herpes virus. It's not the herpes virus that people commonly think of when they hear the word herpes, and so it doesn't cause cold sores. In most people, it actually causes no disease at all, and so people will carry this virus with them for their whole life, and they'll never know it, and they can live a healthy, happy life. For some people, it can cause a devastating disease. Pregnant persons are at risk for transmitting the virus to the developing fetus. About 1 in 200 births, the child will be born with a CMV infection. And in most of those cases, the child will be perfectly fine and healthy. In about 1 in 5 of those cases, the child will be born with a birth defect. The other people that are at risk for this are people who don't have a healthy immune system. Normally, our immune system keeps this virus in check. But if your immune system isn't functioning appropriately, so transplant patients, some cancer patients undergoing treatment, this virus can cause all sorts of diseases, and it can ultimately lead to death in some of them. It's actually pretty common in daycare settings. Kids are running around, they're sharing eating utensils, they're sharing toys, and all of that can be contaminated with saliva or other bodily fluids. And so that's where it's easily transmitted. And then about half of us are infected as an adult, so somewhere between age 5 and adulthood. For some people, they will have an initial signs of infection, and so a sore throat, a slight fever. In more severe cases, they can form mono-like disease, and so some people will be extra tired. But for most of us, we get infected, and we carry this virus, and we just never know it. For the most part, a healthy person does not need to be tested. It's just if they're in a high-risk category. I didn't start by studying CMV or herpes viruses, and actually I tried to avoid studying herpes viruses. These are very large and complex viruses. Even though I've tried to avoid CMV, studying CMV, I've become very passionate about trying to understand it better. It really does teach us a lot about who we are and a lot about how our biology actually works.